NBA legend Wesley Cecil Unseld, simply known as Wes Unseld, passed away at the age of 74 on June 2nd after suffering some health battles, most recently pneumonia. Boy, I gotta tell you, this has been a sad year in 2020 when it comes to the NBA family. I mean, the death of David Stern and Kobe Bryant in the same month in January. Last month, the legendary former Utah Jazz coach Jerry Sloan passed away. And now, the recent legendary NBA player, Wes Unseld. Wes Unseld played 13 seasons in the NBA with the Baltimore/Capitals/Washington Bullets, now known as the Washington Wizards. He was drafted by the Bullets in 1968. During his rookie season, he won MVP and Rookie of the Year. Unseld and Wilt Chamberlain are the only players in NBA history to win MVP and Rookie of the Year during their rookie seasons. That is something. Unseld is one of the greatest centers of all time. He is easily the greatest center in Bullets/Wizards history. I believe he's the second greatest player in Bullets/Wizards history behind Elvin Hayes. Elvin Hayes is easily the greatest Bullets/Wizard of all time in franchise history, as those two are way ahead of John Wall, Gilbert Arenas, and other players who play for the Wizards throughout the history. You know, it's probably some young fans who never saw Wes Unseld or don't know much about him. They're probably going to say, oh, John Wall is like the greatest wizard of all time. And it's like, huh, you better slow your roll and pump your brakes. How about you look a little bit in your history first before you say John Wall is the greatest Bullets/Wizard of all time? It's like, slow your roll, pump your brakes. It's like people nowadays, some, not all, it just seems like most people aren't interested in the history anymore. History when it comes to music and sports, etc. It's like they're allergic to it. It's like they find it contagious and they don't even bother looking up their history. Like they find it lame or it makes them old. It doesn't make you old. It makes you intelligent. And looking up history is very important when it comes to certain having debates with certain people. History is just important. I'm tired of people thinking history is old and it's not right. It is right. Anyways, Wes Unseld's best statistical season was the 1969-70 season, playing all 82 games for the second time of his career and averaging a career-high 16.2 points per game. He won a championship in 1978 with teammate Elvin Hayes. Unseld won finals MVP. He also led Washington to the finals three other times in 1971, losing to the Bucks; 1975, losing to the Warriors; and in 1979, losing to the Sonics. Yeah, that's the same Supersonics that the Bullets beat in 1978, but they didn't go for that repeat, and the Sonics got revenge on them in 1979. It's been almost five decades, 22 years since the last time Washington won a championship, okay? In fact, ever since Wes Unseld retired from the NBA, the Washington Bullets/Wizards have not been to the finals since. So you can see the impact that Wes Unseld had as a player for the Bullets/Wizards during his time in the NBA. It has been a long time since they've been to finals. Unseld was a five-time All-Star from 1969, 71, 72, 73, and 75. All-NBA First Team, 1969. NBA Rookie First Team, 1969. NBA Rebounding Leader, 1975. He won the J. Walter Kennedy Citizenship Award in 1975. He's part of the NBA's 50th anniversary all-time team. The 1980-81 season was Unseld's last season in the NBA, as he only played in 63 games and his jersey was retired shortly thereafter. After his retirement from the NBA, he coached his former team, also served as vice president and general manager for the team in 1996. And ironically, when he was the general manager in 1996, he signed an undrafted player by the name of Ben Wallace, who is, I think, should be a future Hall of Famer. And he known for his best years with the Detroit Pistons. And if you think about it, Wes Unseld, you could say, was like the 70s version of Ben Wallace in his era. Because Ben Wallace is a who's like 6'9". Who could rebound and defend like Wes Unseld. Although Ben Wallace was also a shot blocker, I think he was a better shot blocker than Wes Unseld. And, you know, Wes Unseld was like, what, 6'7", playing the center position? So maybe Wes Unseld saw something in Ben Wallace, and that's why he signed Ben Wallace to the Wizards. Because he saw, you know, Ben Wallace in him during his payday playing in the NBA. Not to mention they both ironically rocked the afros when they played basketball. Wes Unseld had one of the best afros in NBA history. Him, Ben Wallace, definitely Julius Erving. Julius Erving's like the king of afros of the NBA. Just like John Havlicek, Wes Unseld seemed like he was a private person too. So yeah, rest in peace to legendary Wes Unseld. Some people probably look at his stats and they're probably like, how the heck is this guy a Hall of Famer when the guy was only averaging like 10.9 points for his career? You know, based on what they see with today's NBA, where dominant big man or big man, they just seem like they're not important in today's NBA with the no hand check rules and the whole revolution of the three-point shooting, you know? And it's wrong that the way they're using big man nowadays. And it's like, look, don't let the stats fool you. He's a Hall of Famer. Just go look up Wes Unseld to get to know more about him. Don't disrespect Wes Unseld. And it seems like people today really disrespect a lot of NBA legends from the past. I don't understand why. It's like, what do they do to you for you to put them down? Stop disrespecting them. Rest in peace.